Welcome to the ThinkCell tutorials. This video provides step-by-step instructions on how to create scatter and bubble charts with ThinkCell. Scatter charts, also known as scatter plots, are mainly used to show a relationship between pairs of data variables and to help identify patterns in the data as a whole. A scatter chart could, for instance, display the link between two key performance indicators, or KPIs, for a company. The bubble chart is a variant of the scatter chart, with data points marked by bubbles. It is based not on pairs, but triplets of data, with the third data series determining the size of the bubble. To stick to the example, a bubble chart could display the relationship between two KPIs and the annual revenue, represented by the bubble size. Let's see how you can build these chart examples step by step. To insert a scatter chart, go to the ThinkCell group in the PowerPoint ribbon, open the Elements menu, and click on Scatter. Click again to place the chart on the slide. In the first row of the datasheet, you can name the two dimensions of your data. Let's put KPI 1 on the x-axis in column B, and KPI 2 on the y-axis in column C. In our example, we have KPI data for different manufacturing plants of the company. Type in the two values for each plant in separate rows, as each row in the datasheet represents a single data point. Add the names of the plants in the first column for labeling the data points in the chart. The group column in the datasheet can be used to organize individual data points into groups. Type in names for the different groups, in our example, regions. When you insert a group name into a datasheet row, the rows you enter below will automatically be considered part of that group until you fill in a different group name. The data points in the chart are formatted according to the grouping in the datasheet. Right-click onto the chart and select Add Legend to insert a legend for the different groups. Left-clicking on a data point in the legend will select all data points of that group so that you can, for instance, change the format in the drop-down menu. Let's turn to labeling the data points. When you insert a new scatter chart, the data points display point labels by default. Each data point can have up to two labels. Right-click on the chart area, an individual data point, or a multi-selection of them, and pick Add Label or Remove Labels from the right-click context menu. Left-click on the label to open the label content control and choose between displaying text or the values for X, Y, or both. The automatic labeler places labels as close to their data points as possible. If necessary, connecting lines are used to make sure that the labels don't overlap. Finally, as the KPI 1 figures are percentage values, left-click onto any x-axis label and add a percent sign to the number format control box. All labels of the x-axis are changed accordingly. Then repeat this for the point labels by left-clicking onto the KPI 1 value in any of the point labels and typing in a percent sign into the control box. Again, the changes apply to all labels of that type. Let's assume you would like to add a trend line to your scatter chart to graphically represent trends within a group of data points. For example, as part of a regression analysis, ThinkCell calculates the trend line for you. Right-click on a marker of the desired group and select Add Trendline from the context menu. Open the Trendline Type control in the floating toolbar and choose your desired option. Depending on the setup of your chart, you can choose between up to four different types. The linear type is the default and always available. The power type fits best when there is a power law relationship between Y and X values. Choose the exponential type when there is an exponential relationship, or the logarithmic type when your data has a logarithmic relationship. You can also set a trend line representing the average of X values or Y values by picking the corresponding option from the menu. To turn the computed trend line into a freely positioned partition line, just click and drag the line to the desired position. To transform it back into a trend line, left-click on the line, open the Trendline Group Control, and choose which group of data points it should refer to. You may also add fill color to segments of the chart that are separated by trend or partition lines. Let's say you would like to divide your chart up into four quadrants, for example, to build a portfolio. Just add a horizontal partition line by transforming the existing trend line. To do this, select the line and drag the small handle at each end to the middle of the chart. Then right-click onto the chart and pick Add Trend Line Partition to insert a further partition line. Position it vertically. Now hover your mouse over the top right quadrant and left-click onto it. Pick a color from the Fill Color drop-down menu. The quadrant is filled with the respective background color. Repeat this for the other quadrants to color them as well. Now, your scatter chart is complete. Double-click on the chart to open the internal datasheet. As you may have noticed already, column D is headlined Size by default. Adding values to this column will turn your scatter into a bubble chart. Vice versa, deleting all values from the Size column will turn your bubble into a scatter chart. To insert a bubble chart from scratch, open the Elements menu, select Bubble, and click onto the slide once. But let's return to the previous example and assume you would like to augment your chart by adding annual revenue as a third data series to it. Thus, you transform your scatter into a bubble chart in which the size of the bubbles represents the annual revenue. So, double-click on the chart to open the datasheet. As the values for KPI 1 on the X and for KPI 2 on the Y axis are already inserted, start entering the annual revenue for each plant in the size column. Resize the chart if necessary. By default, the size value in the datasheet is proportional to the area of the bubble in the chart. Right-click on the chart and pick Make Diameter Represent Size to set the size proportional to the diameter of a bubble. Add a bubble size legend by right-clicking on the chart and choosing Add Bubble Size Legend. Left-click onto the text label of the legend and type in further information on the meaning of the bubble size. In our case, annual revenue in million US dollars. You can change the bubble size used in the legend by selecting the bubble and dragging the handle that appears on its right boundary. To scale the size of the bubbles inside the chart, select one of them and drag its handle. All other bubbles are scaled accordingly to maintain the correct ratio between them. When two bubbles overlap, the smaller one will be shown in front of the larger one. Right-click on a bubble and select Bring to Front to change this order. To insert a legend for the bubble chart groups, in our case, the regions, right-click on the chart and select Add Legend. Let's say you would like to add partitions into your bubble chart to mark different ranges of values. Right-click on the chart and pick Add Trendline Partition from the context menu. Use the handles at each end to change the angle of the line. Then, make a copy of the line by dragging it while holding down Control. This way, you can easily create parallel lines. Of course, you can also position the copied line differently. Finally, highlight a partition of the chart by hovering your mouse over it, left-clicking onto it, and selecting a background color from the floating toolbar. Repeat this for other partitions. Now, you are done. Your bubble chart is complete. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please visit our website for more ThinkCell tutorials.